So sometimes we find ourselves faced with really hard software testing problems. Let me go over some of the characteristics of these problems. Lack of a specification is common, or perhaps only lack of a good specification. If there are no comparable implementations of the kind of system we're implementing, that is to say it's the first system of its sort, that makes testing quite hard, because what it probably means is we're debugging the specification, or even developing the specification as we go. Big systems are hard to test. Large, highly structured input spaces make testing quite hard. And so if you want to imagine sort of a hard testing problem with a large, highly structured input space, consider, for example, the flight control computers on a spacecraft or on an airplane. These things take sort of an enormous variety of input from all sorts of different redundant sensors. The time at which these inputs arrive is significant. The spacecraft or the airplane has all sorts of physical properties, like its altitude, its attitude, the positions of various control surfaces, that all affect the dynamics. These kind of systems are really, really sort of truly hard to test. Non-determinism can make a system very hard to test. And the issue here is that we'll play a test case against the system once, and it succeeds. But then at some later time, some variable that's not under our control will cause a system to fail on that same input. Lots of hidden state makes systems hard to test. Some systems that I've heard of that are extremely hard to test are, for example, Java virtual machines that are run by, for example, financial organizations on lots of cores with huge amounts of memory. These things have so much internal state that when something goes wrong, it's almost impossible to make any inferences about what was going on inside of it, and you end up needing to try to reproduce the problem. But of course, this is also extremely hard because the problem probably happened 3 hours into some sort of a massive processing task. And finally, if we lack strong oracles, testing can be really hard. And so, for example, something like a large molecular simulation might be very hard to test. So we have some sort of a new simulation code. We have no idea what the right answer is supposed to be, probably. It's running on some sort of a large parallel machine, so we have a very hard time reproducing problems. Problems might take a long time to occur. Something like an autopilot would be extremely hard to test because the response of the thing is going to be inherently in terms of the stability and good behavior of the airplane. And of course, this is an incredibly large, complex physical object that's very hard to model and simulate in a reliable fashion. If you think about making a strong test oracle for an autopilot, this is almost inconceivable. Okay, like I said, some sort of a giant JVM running with lots of cores for a long time, using a huge amount of heap. Very, very hard to test the behavior of something in that kind of a state. So the question we want to ask ourselves is, how do we get a handle on these situations? How should we test these things? And often there aren't really any easy answers. But what we can do is we can leverage weak oracles to the maximum extent possible. If any of these things, the simulation, the autopilot, or the JVM, actually crashes in a bad fashion, then we definitely know something's gone wrong. We can try to bootstrap some degree of confidence in the software under test by taking small test inputs, for which we've hand-checked the output, and trying to argue that, for example, somehow the autopilot, if it responds well for these inputs, also responds well for other test inputs. And in the end, if we're thwarted in our attempts to do really good testing, we probably have to rely on non-testing methods. And so, of course, we should be doing code inspections and using formal methods on our systems in any case if we care about their reliability. But what's happening here, if we really can't test a system effectively, we might have to rely on these things more than we would have liked. Okay, so that's just a quick survey of things that can make testing really hard in practice.